grade annual D.A.R.E. ceremony tonight to thank everyone for coming to share this very special night as we celebrate the completion of the D.A.R.E. curriculum for our fifth grade students. Before we begin tonight, I'd like to acknowledge a few of our distinguished guests that are with us tonight. I'd like to welcome, first of all, the fifth grade teachers, Mr. Smith.
Before we go, we have a student that's been chosen to lead us in the pledge. If people would all stand and join us in the pledge of allegiance with Kelly Gillis.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Kelly was chosen by myself and the teachers because of her speaking voice. She's pretty loud when she wants to be. During the past 17 weeks or so, the students have learned a little bit about their drugs and alcohol and their dangers. They've also learned the value of making proper decisions. And tonight, they're going to show you some of what they learned by performing skits. The skits you're going to see were designed by the students. Their ideas, it's all their work. We only had a few short weeks to prepare, but we're ready to roll tonight. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. The first skit you're going to see is going to be performed by the students from Ms. Richards' class. Is that the first skit ready to go? See one of the dangers of steroids.
This scene takes place at a basketball game at Wilmington High School.
Pressure, you may convince others to follow your lead.
This scene takes place after school in the high school.
Thank you. In our next skit, we're going to get a chance to see that there are even harmful chemicals in common office supplies.
This scene takes place after a girls' softball game at the Wilmington High School.
You guys played a good game.
Thanks.
Hey guys, I'm tomato. Do you want to say something?
Sure.
Here's the dip.
It's sugar.
Andy, you shouldn't do that.
Why?
It messes you up.
Do you guys want to try some?
No, thanks.
Come on, kid.
No, just mine.
Smarter than you.
Next, we see that real friends look out for each other's safety.
This scene takes place in the woods behind the high school on New Year's Eve.
Hey guys, I get some beer at my dad's school. You want to try one?
No thanks.
I'll take some Coke.
Me too.
Come on, refreshing.
Coke's refreshing too.
He's right.
Just one sip.
One sip can get you addicted for life.
Okay, here's your Coke, babies.
I'm tired. I'm gonna go home.
You too.
You better not drive.
I can drive.
No, you can't. Let me see those keys. You drive his car.
Okay, I'll take the monkey home.
Okay.
Our next skit shows us that even legal drugs are dangerous when they're misused.
At Jenny's house when her and two of her friends decide to take diet pills.
Come on, guys. What should we do?
Hey, I got some of my mom's diet pills. You want some?
No way.
He's right. Those are bad for you.
You?
Sure.
Sure.
Hey, sure, they make you feel good.
I can feel good without them. Why shouldn't you take those? Many of them say.
I've been taking them for a while and they haven't hurt me.
And here we get a chance to see one of the many effects of smoking marijuana. Thank you.
scene takes place at a friend's house in Wilmington.
Let's dance.
I'm tired. I'm going to sit down now.
Me too.
Have you guys ever heard of marijuana?
Yeah, that stuff can really mess you up.
That makes you feel good stuff.
Have you ever tried some?
No way.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah,
sure.
By the students, Mr. Smith's class. In the first skit, we see that drinking and driving often leads to bad news. Thank you.
kids pick on Jeff every day at school, and this is his solution.
I'm sick of O.J. Simpson child. I'm sick of those kids taking on me. This gun will solve my problems.
Jeff, what do you think he's doing? Put the gun back. Mom's gonna kill you.
Come on, you have to promise you won't tell.
I can't. Look what happened to me when I thought I was a fool.
Jeff, Dad, time for school.
No, I'm not you. Come on, let's go.
Fine.
At school. Jeff when he thought guns were cool. We'll see what that would have been like without the gun.
I'm sick of O.J. Simpson trial, and I'm sick of those kids taking on me. Gun will solve all my problems.
Jeff, what do you think you're doing? Put the gun back. Mom's gonna kill you.
Come on, you have to tell you.
I can't. Look what happened to me when I thought guns were cool.
Jeff just got time for school. Did I hear guns?
No.
Jeff just said she wants to be a nun.
That's right.
In reality, you can't change the choice you made, so we hope you made the right choice.
One of the many consequences of alcohol abuse.
A few hours later.
I think we should go home.
Let's stay in the fence, Chris. Just stay.
Next, we see that making friends the wrong way can get you in trouble. Attention up to the big screen. We have a little slideshow for you tonight.
We'll be right back. I was wondering where we got the skeletal remains that was all of Mrs. Smith. That was pretty neat, I thought. But it could have been one of our Celtics from back in the, you know, maybe the 1800s or something. We don't, we're going a little chippy this year. You guys miss him for that couple of weeks in school?
Yeah.
You know why he came back as quick as he did? Because I told him I was going to give Mr. White the D.A.R.E. card if he didn't get back. And he did go home with the ID still in. But I get to grade him tonight because this is our final graduation for the D.A.R.E. program this year. And being Officer Bruce's first year, I think it's important to commend him. I think the efforts and the dedication he put into this did. It's a credit not just to yourselves, but also to Officer Bruce. And I want to give him a big round of applause. As usual, I have a list of people I have to thank also, as well as Mr. Mark and all, and certainly the staff here at the school is perhaps the next most important thing to the parents and students. And we greatly appreciate what you do here, because without it, we wouldn't have the mutual effort that we have. And certainly without my boss, the town manager, the board of selectmen, and the school committee, none of these programs would be possible. Wilmington is fortunate that we have a community which looks at problems not as school problems, police problems, or town government problems, but Wilmington's fortunate that we look at problems as community problems. We look at solutions as community solutions, and by working together, we accomplish far more than those communities who tend to still refer to it as school problems, police problems, DPW problem. As we move into the 21st century, we talk about community policing. That's something that's very near and dear to my heart, because I think that that's something that will still be evolving after I retire from this department. Community policing is not something that you put into effect one day and you say, we're going to start this in October 1994 and it begins. It's a process, a revolution. Change. It's a police department, a community working together to answer the needs and to solve the problems of this community. I think we're moving in that direction. I commend my people. More importantly, I commend you, the citizens. Programs such as this would not be possible if you did not allow your young people to participate. It is a voluntary program within the school. Pleased to say that in each of our elementary schools, we have 100% participation. There's never been a lack of participation. But it is voluntary, not a mandatory thing. So without your support and your reinforcement of what Officer Bruce teaches, nothing we do could be successful. And the people I have to thank the most are you guys. I thought those skits were some of the best skits I've seen here at the Wildwood School since we started this program out 7 years. An awful lot of thought went into it. And I want you to remember that. As Mr. Osmond said, when if you leave here tonight, look around, look at those people out in that audience. You will see people in your life, many of them, whether it be an O.J. Simpson, Lennon Bias, or someone else, who may fail in life, may be a disappointment to you. Sometimes we put our heroes on too high a shelf. And we don't really only have to look right in our own home sometimes to see the biggest hero in our life. Our mother, our father, our brothers, our sisters, our grandmothers, grandfathers. They're the most important people in your life. They'll be there if you ever need them throughout the rest of your life, as long as they live. While we can't be part of that family, we do want to be part of your family and the community. Officer Bruce, Officer White, Chidro, Lieutenant Spencer, each of the officers in this department that you know, Officer Shelley, and probably Officer King as well, they're always there. They care about you, they have a problem, you need to talk to someone, come to us. We want to be there for you. We want to be your friend. We want to help you make the right decision. As you go on into the intermediate school, we're not going to be leaving you now. As you know, there's, as of last year, we began an intermediate school program where the officer group will now be with you and one of the intermediate students. And as of the fall, we'll be beginning the program in the high school. So we want to stay involved throughout your educational career. Again, I want to say thank you for your efforts and what you did here tonight. I look forward to congratulating you on receiving your certificate. Thank you again.
You have to grow, you're going to have to shrink one of the others. I can leave it up there, Mr. Smith, you're going to use it too. It's time for your certificates. We're going to have, as customary with the D.A.R.E. program, all the students receive a certificate of appreciation upon graduation. So with the help of the classroom teachers, Mr. Osmond and Chief Stewart will present those certificates now. Be careful, kids, when you come up here, don't trip over the cord.
Megan Gallant. Kelly Gillis. Mike Harrow. Rochelle Jones. Amanda Carrigan. John Lemke. Jenny McNeil. Jason Manette. Brian Martinello. Dan McCarthy. Billy McGarry. Lindsay McKenna. Colleen McMahon. Ariana Mills. Stephen Natoli. Andrew Petrella. Sarah Larka. Vanessa Leonard. Heather Roberts. Leanne Shirley. Stephen Smith. Mark Stewart. Jeff Stokes. Ryan Thibodeau. Amanda Von Herman. Kathleen Walsh. 1978.
John Connolly. Brian Cochran. Christine DeMango. Timothy Elliott. Jennifer Gillis. Solomon Gordon. Deborah Graham. Jeffrey Potter. Peter Hogan. Andrew Holland. Sarah Hubbard. Robert Jaganinski. Christopher McHale. Eric Meixler. Christopher Mingella. Andrew Palano. Stephanie Clinton. Krista Roberts. Robert Rosillo. Jacqueline Rubino. Jessica Saperito. Kristen Solve. Lindsay Scott. Catherine Sullivan. Ashley Guerra. Tony Marie Mula. Lauren Whitfield. Stephanie Lynn. Sarah Zimmerman. Backwards, sideways, stylish crew you are. Before we leave tonight, I'd like to take the time myself to thank some people. First, I certainly want to thank the staff here at the Wildwood School. Without them, I couldn't do a program like this. Anything I needed, they supplied it, top to bottom. Thank you, people, very much. I want to thank my assistants tonight. My predecessor, Officer White, Officer Chalou, and the man behind the camera, Officer Harris. I'd like to thank the town manager, he's been to all three of our graduations. Thank you for your presence. Members of the Board of Selectmen, represented by my dad. Thanks, Dad. Thanks for coming along. And the members of the school committee who have been represented all three graduations, by Mr. Brad Jackson. Thank you. Of course, I have to thank the teachers, Ms. Richards, Mr. Smith, make my life easy in the classroom. The kids are always prepared and ready to go. Without them, I couldn't do this. Thank you. And certainly, you, the parents and family members of our students. Without your support at home, the D.A.R.E. program doesn't carry the strength it needs to carry. We need to work together, the police department, the schools, and you, the parents. The three of us together need to work together and fight the drug war. We need to protect our nation's greatest resource, our children. We need to look after them now so they can look after us later. Thank you for coming and for your support. Certainly, I have to thank the students. I had a fun year with a lot of your help. The cooperation was greatly appreciated. All the cards and things like that when I was in the hospital, that was appreciated. Thank you very much. A couple words. I'll be in touch. Like the chief said, we have a seventh grade program, so I'll be in touch. I'll see you in the middle schools. Keep an eye on you. We hope to have some programs for you in the summer. Keep you busy if we can. In the meantime, be careful, behave, stay safe, and stay drug free. Thank you. Before our final song that has become tradition and customary with the D.A.R.E. program, I want to remind you that the packet supplied refreshments and snacks, and they are in the back, and there's a table of D.A.R.E. items out in the hallway that people can help yourself to. But now, our students have a little song they want to sing for you.